Hello everyone, I'm Lorenzo Veronese, a PhD student at TU Vin, and today I'm presenting Bulwark, Holistic and Verified Security Monitoring of Web Protocols. This is a joint work with Stefano Calzavara from Ca' Foscari University in Venice and Luca Compagna from SAP Labs France. In this talk, I will start by giving you an example of a web protocol and show you how it is possible to attack it. I will then describe the state of the art and discuss the design space for a security monitor for web protocols. I will present our approach for generating formally verified security monitors and describe our experimental evaluation. Finally, I will conclude by describing possible future work. Let us start by having a look at a web protocol. We will see now an example run of the explicit mode of OAuth 2.0. This protocol allows a website called Relying Party to use a trusted third party, Facebook in this example, for authenticating a user which operates a user agent, a browser. From now on, I will use the abbreviated names RP for Relying Party and TTP for trusted third party. The protocol starts when the user visits the website login page. Here, the RP provides a button that, when clicked, sends a request to the TTP. This request contains the identifier of the RP at TTP, the client ID, an URL to which the TTP needs to redirect the user at the end of the login, the redirect URI, and the state, a fresh value that is used by the website to maintain session binding with the user agent. Now, the user authenticates with the trusted third party, which redirects the user back to the redirect URI of the RP without an authorization code. The RP verifies the validity of the code in a backchannel exchange with the TTP, which acknowledges the validity of the code by generating an authentication token. Finally, the website confirms the successful authentication to the user agent. The secure implementation of these protocols is far from easy, as I will show you in a moment. I highlighted here two invariance relations between the parameters that are used during the protocol run. The state parameter that is sent at step 7 needs to be the same as the one that is generated at step 2. The authorization code and the redirect URI sent at step 8 needs to equal the values that this parameter had at step 6 and 3. We can exploit the lack of these invariant checks in the implementations in different ways. The session swapping attack is possible on RPs that do not use or validate the state parameter. The attacker logs into the TTP and obtains a valid authorization code. The attacker then tricks the honest user through a cross-site request forgery to send the attacker code to the RP, which makes the victim authenticate at the RP with the attacker identity. Similarly, in this other attack, the TTP does not strictly validate the redirect URI. The attacker tricks the victim into starting the protocol flow using the honest RP client ID, but an attacker-controlled redirect URI. When the user authenticates with the TTP, the attacker obtains the victim authorization code, and she can use it to log in as the victim at RP. As you can see, the lack or the incorrect implementation of simple invariant checks allows an attacker to swap her session with the victim or completely hijack the victim account. Let us now have a look at the previous proposals for security monitoring of web protocols. In general, no approach is able to protect the entire attack surface, as each work makes strong assumptions on the placement of the monitors. They deploy them either on the client side by using browser extensions or at the server side by using proxy servers. Client-side-only solutions are not able to observe attacks that are detectable by the server side, and the proposed proxy servers either do not offer protection on the TTP or they are not designed for multi-party applications. Also, most proposals are not designed with formal verification in mind, with the exception of WPSI. They derive, for example, an expected protocol run from the network traces, but they do not provide guarantees about the security of this expected run. Starting from this analysis of the related work, we want to analyze the design space for security monitors. As the previous works, we consider both browser extensions and server-side proxies, but we also make another proposal. The Service Worker API is a new browser functionality that enables websites to define JavaScript workers that act as proxy servers but are executed in the background by the browser. This allows us to deploy client-side security monitors from the server by including JavaScript files. Service workers, however, are still subject to the same origin policy, so they can only observe the traffic exchange between the browser and the origin that registered them. We evaluate the effectiveness of the various solutions across different axes. Let us start with the ease of deployment and usability. Here, we take into account the practicality of the large-scale deployment of the monitor to every user of the website, the effort that is needed by site operators for the deployment, and then how the presence of the monitor have an impact on the user experience. In these first two axes, the browser extension is in clear disadvantage. Though installing a browser extension is straightforward, we cannot assume that every user will perform this manual installation step. Site operators could require the installation of the extension to access the web app, but this would have a major impact on usability. Proxies have the advantage of providing transparent protection to users. However, they require site operators to have control over the server networking and reroute connections to the proxy. This is typically easy for the TTP, as it is usually a big company, but it might be a problem for some RPs that are deployed on hosting platforms that allow modifications only to the application code. Finally, service workers are the best solution for what regards usability and ease of deployment, as they require site operators to only add a JavaScript file. When user visit the application, the service worker is transparently installed without user interaction. For what regards protection and compatibility, we have to take into account the visibility of the attack surface. Here, browser extensions and reverse proxies are complementary in their ability to observe the protocols, as extensions can inspect values that never leave the user agent, like the fragment identifier, and proxies have the visibility over the back channels between servers, where browsers are not involved. Service workers are strictly less powerful than their alternatives. Even if they are able to, like extension, observe client-only values, they are limited by the same origin policy. Let us now have a look at a list of known attacks against web protocols. In the table, you can see a selection of known attacks against OAuth 2.0. For each attack, we show which channels are needed to be visible to detect the vulnerability and if the attack can be prevented by an extension, a service worker or proxy on the RP or TTP. In general, we can see that the browser extension is the most powerful tool, as it can mitigate most of the attacks by itself. The exception is the last attack that can be only detected by the TTP. What's interesting is that the service worker on both the RP and TTP offers a comparable amount of protection, but have issues when these service workers need to inspect cross-origin values. Finally, we can see that by using a combination of service workers and proxies, we can offer transparent protection that performs better than browser extensions. When we look at the PayPal payment protocol, we can see a very different trend. Even if it's possible to detect attacks on the browser side, it is not safe to do so, because malicious customers of a shop can tamper with the protection mechanism, as they are in control of the browser. This was not the case for single sign-on, as there, the target of the attack are usually honest users. Here, the target is usually the shop itself, where the attacker wants to shop for less or for free. PayPal also makes heavy use of backchannels exchange between the RP and TTP, as messages that are not relayed by the browser cannot be tampered with by malicious customers. This means that server-side proxies are our only solution to protect PayPal-like payment protocols. The overall outcome of our design space analysis is that the combination of service workers and proxies is a sweet spot in the design space. This allows us to have an easy-to-deploy monitor that has enough visibility of the attack surface to mitigate all known attacks. In our approach, we follow this direction. Work generates formally verified security monitors from applied PyCalculus specifications of web protocols. It builds on top of Proverif, a state-of-the-art protocol verification tool, and uses the WebSpy library. Bulwark starts from a Proverif model of the web protocol, called IDEA specification, and generates executable security monitors deployed as service worker or proxies. This process uses an intermediate step called monitored specification, in which the tool verifies the deployment options for the monitors. The workflow is summarized in the figure, and in a moment I will give you more details on each step. I want first to explain the intended use case of Bulwark. We focus on the TTP side, being it an identity provider or a payment gateway. With the integration of its services, the TTP usually provides its customers with some documentation and an SDK. However, the ERP is still required to write some code, and SDKs cannot prevent all errors, as they may be misused or contain implicit assumptions. Bulwark allows to strengthen the TTP offer by adding monitors that, when deployed on the ERP, ensure a protected integration. The TTP, which has the best knowledge of the protocol it offers, starts by writing down a Proverif specification expressing the intended security properties in terms of correspondence assertions and security queries. The protocol encodes the behavior of all protocol participants and is written using the WebSpy library, with models, standard web browsers, and includes support for the important threats of the web security literature. The protocol specification is automatically verified for security violations, and the TTP iteratively applies the fixes until Proverif does not report any flaw. This leads to a security proof for an unbounded number of sessions, up to the model of WebSpy. The WebSpy model, although expressive, is not a complete model of the web. It, however, models enough components of the mother web to capture all the attacks against web protocols that are present in the literature. Once the verification is complete, the TTP can use Bulwark to generate security monitors for both the ERP and its own implementation. In this phase, Bulwark relaxes the assumption that all protocol participants are implemented correctly. In particular, user-selected participants are replaced by their inattentive variant. This inattentive variant complies with the protocol flow, but forgets relevant security checks. This approximates honest but buggy participants, which are interoperable with the other parties, but whose requests and responses are a superset of the original ones. Bulwark then extracts from the IDEA specification all the security checks forgotten by the inattentive participants and centralizes them within security monitors. This is done by applying two functions, the A2MP and A2MSW, which derive from the IDEA specification process an abstract server-side proxy or an abstract service worker. In the monitored specification, each inattentive participant deploys a monitor, both at the client and at the server side. However, this might be overly conservative, so to optimize ease of deployment, Bulwark run again Proverif on all possible deployment options, starting from the most convenient one until it finds a setting which satisfies the security properties of the IDEA specification. I will now show you, with an example, how the ERP of the OAuth 2.0 protocol is replaced by its inattentive variant. On the right, you can see the ideal ERP process, with a few more details on its internals. When the ERP receives the first message, it generates a new value for the state parameter, and it saves it in its internal storage, together with the user agent session identifier. When the ERP receives message 7, it checks the received state against the value that was previously stored for that user session. The inattentive variant is shown on the left, together with the abstract proxy generated by the I2MP function. We can see that in the inattentive version the state is not saved or checked. However, we can see that the saving and checking is performed by the monitor. Note that the monitor can save the state parameter only upon reception of message 2 from the inattentive ERP. For this inattentive ERP, the possible monitor deployments are three: the service worker alone, the proxy alone, and both the service worker and the proxy. Bulwark runs ProveReth in these three settings, stopping when the security properties of the idea specification are satisfied. The abstract monitor processes are finally translated into executable service workers written in JavaScript or proxies written in Python. This is a relatively direct one-to-one translation, and the key challenge is to map the ProveReth messages to real HTTP messages. As an example, different RPs integrating the same TTP will host the protocol at different URLs. HTTP also might use different parameter names or different encodings with respect to the other. We deal with this problem by means of a configuration file, which defines concrete values for symbols and data constructors. Since these mappings are written directly in the target language, different implementations can be generated for the same monitor. A single specification created for the Google TTP, for example, can be easily ported to others, as an example Facebook, by tuning the configuration file. To evaluate the effectiveness of Bulwark, we first wrote the IDEA specifications for OAuth 2.0 and PayPal, defining appropriate security policies to rule out all known attacks. Then we set up 8 case studies. For the OAuth 2.0 scenario, we start from a completely artificial case study, where we develop both the RP and TTP and introduce known vulnerabilities. We then consider the vulnerable integration with three major TTPs. Finally, we consider a case study where we have no control over any party, the integration between Overleaf and Google. The lack of state parameter in the Overleaf implementation introduced known vulnerabilities. We responsibly disclosed the issue to Overleaf and they fixed it before the publication. For the payment scenario, we select legacy versions of three popular open source e-commerce platforms that suffer from known vulnerabilities in the integration with PayPal. For each case study, we generate security monitors and deploy them together with the vulnerable application, evaluating each monitor in terms of four aspects: security, we check if the monitor mitigates the vulnerability; compatibility, we check if the monitor breaks legitimate protocol runs; portability, we check if our IDEA specification can be used without significant change across case studies; and performance. The results are shown in the table. Here you can see which inattentive participant we chose for each case study, the generated monitors, and the time spent to verify the IDEA specification and the deployment. In all case studies, we confirm that the vulnerabilities were prevented when the monitor were deployed, and we were able to complete legitimate protocol runs correctly. We can see that the IDEA specification that was developed for the first case study is portable to the first four without any change. In the same way, the PayPal specification was portable to all the RPs. This tells us that once an IDEA specification is created for a protocol, it's then straightforward to reuse it to other integrations based on the same protocol. The runtime of Bulwark is dominated by the two verification steps. However, these steps never require more than 90 minutes, and they are executed offline and just once, so these times are perfectly fine for practical adoption. So, in conclusion, we identified the shortcomings in previous work on security monitoring of web protocols. We proposed Bulwark, the first holistic and formally verified defensive solution in this research area. We combined the state-of-the-art protocol verification tools and modern web technologies to reconcile formal verification and practical security. We showed that Bulwark can generate effective monitors on different case studies based on OAuth 2.0 and PayPal. As a future work, we plan to extend Bulwark to add additional protection layers, like client-side communication based on JavaScript and the PostMessage API. This is important to support modern SDKs that make heavy use of these technologies, like the latest PayPal SDK. On the formal side, we want to strengthen our definition of inattentive participant to cover additional vulnerabilities. For example, we plan to cover participants who forget to include the relevant security headers. Finally, we want to make Bulwark easier for people with no experience with ProveReth, For example, by including a graphical or simplified notation. Thank you for your attention.